वेलकम बैक माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाह व बरकातुहु। एज वी नो दैट वी वर डिस्कसिंग द प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टू प्रॉपर्टीज, टाइम ऑफ फ्लाइट एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल रेंज। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग मैक्सिमम हाइट अटेन्ड, वी विल डिस्कस हियर हॉरिजॉन्टल रेंज, वन मोर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ हॉरिजॉन्टल रेंज हियर, दैट वी नो दैट हॉरिजॉन्टल रेंज इज ट्वाइस यू साइन थीटा u square sin of 2 theta divided by g. So this is the property of a horizontal range, mathematical relation of horizontal range. We will discuss one more important point related to that. We know that the horizontal range is maximum at theta is equal to 45 degree. So we know that at theta is equal to 45 degree, our horizontal range is maximum, and that is our max is at that time is equal to u square upon g, because it will be sine of 90 after putting theta is equal to 45 degree, sine 90 is equal to 1. Now remember one more point, my dear students, that when we project a projectile at two different angles, like suppose at theta and 90 degree minus theta, if we project a projectile at angle theta and 90 degree theta, like suppose if I project a projectile at angle of 30 degree, if I project a projectile at an angle of 30 degree, another same projectile of same mass with same initial velocity, I will project at 90 minus 30 means at 60 degree. The range of both the situation, the range at 30 degree and range at 60 degree is same. Now let us prove it here. How we prove it? Very simple. So again, I will take here projectile. Let us suppose the angle of projection in beginning is theta. So definitely my horizontal range is r is equal to u square sine of 2 theta divided by g, isn't it? Now I will change the angle of projection. Now I will put the angle of projection here 90 degree minus theta, like this. But initial velocity and mass of the projectile is same. Initial velocity and mass of projectile is same, but angle of projection I change. I put here now 90 degree minus theta. Let us suppose in this case I will put the range is r prime. Here the range is now r prime. So what will be my new range r prime? That will be equal to u square sine of, now the angle is not theta, angle is now 90 minus theta. It means twice 90 degree minus theta. Here the angle was theta, it was 2 theta. Now the angle is 90 minus theta, now it become twice 90 minus theta divided by g. Students, it will become as my dear students, r prime is equal to u square sine of 180 degree minus theta divided by g. This is the property of trigonometric function, that sine 180 degree minus theta is equal to sine of theta. Sine, also it will come here 2 theta. Sine 180 degree minus theta is sine theta. Sine of 180 degree minus phi, let us suppose phi, it is not necessary theta always, is equal to sine of phi. Here phi is 2 theta. So what I will get, the range will be equal to u square sine of twice theta divided by g. Why? Because sine 180 degree minus phi is equal to sine phi. Here instead of phi, here it is 2 theta, so it will become sine of 2 theta. So we can come to know that r prime is equal to u square sine 2 theta divided by g is equal to r. So range of the projectile is same at theta and at 90 degree minus theta. So you remember, this is very important property of horizontal range, that horizontal range is same at angle theta and at angle 90 minus theta. Now let us move ahead. Now my dear students, let us discuss the maximum height attained. We need this equation, we write here it. Maximum height, it is the maximum vertical distance covered by the projectile during its motion. Maximum vertical distance मैक्सिमम वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय प्रोजेक्टाइल, मैक्सिमम वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय प्रोजेक्टाइल ड्यूरिंग इट्स मोशन एट हाइएस्ट पॉइंट. One is the projectile reaches to the highest point of its path like this. This is the highest point of its path here. The vertical component of velocity is equal to zero and the horizontal component of velocity Vx that is equal to Ux and that is equal to U cos theta as we have discussed in the previous lecture, having the initial velocity U here and here it is angle theta. And this component is u cos theta and this component along y axis is u sin theta. So at highest point there is a maximum vertical distance. So maximum vertical distance at highest point, this maximum vertical distance is called maximum height and we are denoting this maximum height with capital H. So this is a maximum height, it is a maximum vertical distance at highest point. So this is H. So how we derive this? We will derive it like this. We will write the relation Sy is equal to S is equal to ut plus 1 half of at square uyt plus 1 half of ayt square. This is the equation or it is the displacement of the projectile at any time t in vertical direction, isn't it? Now let's suppose this is this such a point at any time t. So we can say Sy is equal to y at any point P, its vertical distance is y here and the horizontal distance we will take x. Uy is initial velocity in vertical direction, that is u sin theta into t minus 1 upon 2 because we are taking this Ay as a minus g because acceleration due to gravity is downwards by convention into t square. Now my dear students, one is the projectile reaches to the highest point, your vertical distance, this y is equal to this h and the velocity in the vertical direction that is equal to zero. So I will write here at highest point, at highest point my y is equal to h. As it is clear, when I reach here at highest point, this y is now equal to h and my time t, the time taken by the projectile from this point of projection up to highest point, that is called time of ascent. So let us say that is always half of the time of flight, so that is t upon 2. And we know that, my dear student, let's put all these values. So what we will get after putting these values, I will get my h is equal to u sin theta into t, it is half of the time of flight, minus g by 2 into t by 2 square. Now my dear students, we know that time of flight, that is equal to twice u sin theta divided by g. Let us calculate here time of ascent or time of descent, that means half of the time of flight, that is equal to u sin theta divided by g. So let us put the value here. So what will be my h? My h will be, my dear students, u sin theta into t by 2, put the value here, u sin theta divided by g, I put the value of t by 2 here, minus g upon 2 into here t by 2, again t by 2 is this, so I will put here u square sin square theta divided by g square. Because my dear students, here it is square, t by 2 square, so it will become u square sin square theta divided by g square. Now let us move ahead. So what will be our resultant equation? My resultant equation will be this 1 g and g will one cancel, so this is equal to maximum height attained is by cross multiplication, this will be u square sin square theta divided by g minus u square sin square theta divided by 2 g. So let us take this u square sin square theta here common, so I will write it is h is equal to u square sin square theta divided by g, here it will remain as 1 minus 1 upon 2. So what I will get here, maximum height attained is equal to u square sine square theta divided by 2s g. So this is the equation for maximum height attained by the projectile during its motion. So h is equal to u square sine square theta divided by 2s g. Now let us see, when horizontal range is maximum, then at that time what will be the maximum height attained? So let us discuss this important property here. I will write here, at theta is equal to 45 degree, maximum horizontal range, that is equal to u square upon g. We know it, that is u square upon g. What will be the maximum height attained? So I will see first here, sine of 45 degree here, that is equal to 1 upon square root of 2. Once it is sine square theta, means sine square of 45 degree, that is equal to 1 upon 2. So after putting the value, so what will be the maximum height attained at that time? Height will be h is equal to u square divided by 2s g into sine square theta. Here theta is 45 degree, that will become equal to 1 upon 2 again. So I will get here u square divided by 4 times g, but maximum height attained or max, that is u square by g. So that means my h is equal to r max divided by 4. So remember this important property, this is used in numericals. The maximum horizontal range for a projectile is at theta is equal to 45 degree. So maximum horizontal range at theta is equal to 45 degree, and the maximum horizontal range is u square by g. What will be the maximum height attained? What will be the height, vertical height attained, maximum height at that time at theta is equal to 45 degree? That is equal to r max divided by 4. Now let us discuss one more property related to the projectile motion, velocity at any time t. We know that initially it is velocity is u, and along x-axis it is u cos theta, and along y-axis it is u sine theta. But at any time during its motion, we want to determine its velocity. So let us take another property related to it. Velocity of projectile at any time t. Okay, now my dear students, let us see here again this is a projectile motion, and we throw the projectile with some initial velocity u, with some angle theta with the horizontal. So this is ux, u cos theta, and this is uy as u sin theta. Initial velocities, we know that this vertical direction velocity, it gets decreased up to highest point, then it increases in the same rate in the downward direction, but this component remains unchanged. Let us suppose here the velocity of projectile at any time t is v of t. So v of t, what is v of t? It is velocity of projectile at any time t. At any time t. Now it will have components. One component of it will be, my dear students, along x-axis, that will be vx t, and one will be along y-axis, vy of t. So what is vx and vx of t and vy of t? These are the components of velocity at this point, at this time t, at this point p, when time is t, along x-axis and along y-axis. Let us calculate these values. Vxt, velocity of projectile at any time t along x-axis, that will be equal to ux into t plus ax into, like this, ux plus ax into t, because we know that kinematic equation v is equal to u plus at. I will use this relation here. Now we know that ux, that is u cos theta, u cos theta, and ax acceleration in horizontal direction is 0, so plus 0 into t. So remember vx of t is equal to u cos theta. This is the velocity along the horizontal direction. Now let us calculate the velocity in vertical direction, vy of t. That will be equal to uy plus ay into t. So that will be simply initial velocity along y-axis is u sin theta. So I will write here u sin theta here. Then ay acceleration along y-axis, that is acceleration due to gravity, that is downwards. So by convention that is taken negative into t. So this is vy at any time t. Now let us calculate the resultant velocity. As these are vectors, let us calculate the resultant velocity. What will be the resultant velocity, my dear students? Resultant velocity here I will calculate. That will be, my dear students, v at any time t, that will be equal to square root of vx at time t plus vy at time t. No, vx into t plus vy t plus twice vx vy t into cos of theta, because theta is here 90 degree. Angle between vx t and vy t is 90, so cos 90 is 0. So no need to write a third term. So only we will write vx, rather square, because we know that r is equal to under root of a square plus b square. When the two vectors, vector a and vector b, if they are perpendicular, then the magnitude of resultant vector is equal to this. So same is the case here. So what will be v of t, velocity at any time t? That will be square root of, now vxt, that is u cos theta, means u square cos square theta plus, now vyt square means u sin theta minus gt square, like this. Now let us expand this. So once we will expand it, very simple, u square cos square theta plus u square sin square theta plus g square t square minus twice u sin theta into gt, like this, after expanding by using a plus b whole square. So what will you get our resultant equation? We will get our resultant equation as like this. We will get our resultant equation, v at any time t is equal to, now my dear students, here it is cos square theta, here it is sin square theta, and u square is common factor. You can take it here, u square cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is equal to 1. Then I will take plus g square t square, then minus twice u g t sin theta. Now this is equal to 1 as per that is a trigonometric identity. So v of t will be equal to then square root of u square plus g square t square minus twice u g t sin theta. So this is the velocity of projectile at any time t. This is the velocity of projectile at any time t. Now let us calculate the velocity of projectile when it touches to ground. Let us calculate here velocity. Now how we calculate it? So I will see here, at t is equal to capital T, I want to find velocity at t is equal to capital T, means when it touches to ground, that is when projectile touches to ground. When projectile touches to ground, we will want to determine the velocity at that time. So how we will calculate it? So we put t is equal to small t is equal to capital T. So velocity at capital T function is a function of capital T here. So it will be equal to square root of u square plus g t square minus twice u g t sin theta.
Let us put the value of t here. T is time of flight. So let us put the value of time of flight here. So we know that, my dear students, time of flight is twice u sine theta divided by g. Let us put the value here. So we know that t is equal to 2u sine theta divided by g. This is equation for time of flight. Let us divide both sides by 2. Once you divide with 2 both sides, so I will get t by 2 is equal to u sine theta divided by g. So put the value of t here. Put the value of t here, or we can generally write here. No, to directly you put the value of 2u sine theta divided by g here. So what I will get? I will get v of t is equal to square root of u square plus g square into t square. Means here 4u square sine square theta divided by g. 4u square sine square theta divided by g square. Then minus twice u g into, here it is gt. Here it is gt. Here it is a product gt. I can directly write 2u sine theta. So I will directly write here. I will directly write here 2u into 2u sine theta into one more sine theta. That will be sine square theta then. Sine square theta. So after putting the value of t in this equation, we will get this. So this g square will cancel with the g square. So velocity of the projectile when it touches to ground, that will be equal to u square then plus 4 times u square sine square theta minus 2 to the 4 u sine square theta, and it will be again u square. It will be 4 times u square sine square theta. So this will cancel with this. So we will get this is square root of u square, and that means velocity of projectile at any time t is equal to u, and you have proved this. So we proved that the speed with which we are projecting the projectile, suppose I project some projectile with a speed of 100 km per hour, then once the projectile touches to ground, it will touch with the ground with the same speed of 100 km per hour, but with different direction. The initial direction is like, I will show you here. Initial direction is this, like this, this u, this is initial direction, but the final direction will be in this way, like this. So magnitude will be same, but remember, condition is that there is no external force except gravity. There is no air resistance. My dear students, in future lecture, we will also discuss now the numericals related to the projectile motion, because in competitive exams, one or two questions are definitely from this topic. I hope you will do best in future, work hard, and you know that the hard work plus luck gives success. Thank you, my dear students, for your patience. God bless you. Stay at safe, stay at home.